Good morning, dear students. Myself Sharda Devre, Associate Professor, Government College of Pharmacy, Amravati, Maharashtra. Today we will learn the topic regulatory issues of ASU drugs, that is Ayurvedic Siddha Yunani drugs. In India, drugs that are medicines are regulated under the Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940. There is a Central Drug Standard Control Organization called as CDSCO under Directorate General of Health Services of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. This CDSCO forms DTAB, that is a Drug Technical Advisory Board, and DCCC, that is a Drugs Consultative Committee. Both these bodies give the recommendations if required on the matters of administration of the Drugs and Cosmetic Acts and rules thereunder throughout the country. Similarly, there exist ASU DTAB, that is a Ayurvedic Siddha Yunani Drugs Technical Advisory Board under separate Chapter 4A in the Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940, which regulates the manufacturing, sale, packaging, labeling of ASU drugs for domestic use and for export. It also regulates the penalty for manufacture and sale of ASU drugs in contravention of these rules and for misbranded, adulterated and spurious ASU drugs. The ASU DTAB comprises officials and nominees of central government, pharmacognosist, phytochemist, members of the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia Committee, Siddha Pharmacopoeia Committee and Yunani Pharmacopoeia Committee, representatives of teachers, practitioners and ASU drugs industry person nominated by central government. The central government has also constituted an ASU DCCC, that is Ayurveda Siddha and Yunani Drugs Consultative Committee, under the Act to advise to the ASU DTAB as well as central and state governments in the matter for the purpose of securing uniformity throughout the India in the administration of the Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940 in relation with the ASU drugs. There is also the specific law, that is the Drugs and Magic Remedies Act 1954. This particular law regulates the prevention of objectionable advertisements and publicity relating to certain drugs and magic remedies for treatment of certain identified diseases and disorders. All we know that in our country, most of such objectionable advertisements and publicity related to the herbal drug is a major concern, and this law is perfect for regulating such a type of the unethical claims. Further regulation of manufacturing of ASU drugs is through the good manufacturing practices, that is a GMP for ASU drugs under the Schedule T of the Indian Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940 and Rules 1945. According to this particular Schedule T, it is mandatory compliance from the licensed manufacturer with regard to the raw materials, manufacturing area, manufacturing process, record keeping, storage of raw materials and finished products, and quality testing. It is must to ensure the strict compliance of GMP by ASU drugs manufacturers, or it will lead to the cancellation of the license if there is a non-GMP compliant unit is found. Strict compliance by state drug controllers, licensing authorities for display of all the ingredients along with the quantities contained in the formulations on the label or container or a leaflet inserted inside the container since 2005. It is very necessary that all the ingredients that are added in preparing the herbal formulation should be on a label with a quantity. Exporters of purely herbal ASU drugs have been directed to mandatory testing for heavy metals and either conspicuously display on the container of purely herbal ASU drugs words heavy metals within permissible limits or furnish the above certificate from the authorized laboratories. It means that with the concern raised in most of the countries related to the presence of heavy metals in Indian medicines, these particular rules are very promising. Then use of permissible excipients, preservatives for increasing the shelf life of ASU drugs and draft rules for expiry date has also been notified under Indian Cosmetic Act 1940. The issue of safety of herbo-mineral, herbo-metallic like bhasmas or other compound is also being addressed by the central government through one very important project that is called as the Golden Triangle Project, and that is carried out by CSIR laboratories. In this particular project, 8 most widely used rasa aushadhis, bhasmas, namely kajali, rasa manikya, nagabhasma, rasa sindur, basanta kusumkar ras, arogya vardhinivati, maha yogaraj gugul, and mahalakshmi vilas ras. There are further provisions in Drugs and Cosmetic Acts and Rules with special reference to the ASU drugs. Let's see these provisions one by one. Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940, Chapter 4A, Section 33B to 33N provides provisions related to the Ayurveda, Siddha and Unani drugs. The first schedule of this particular act, there is a list of scheduled books. There are total 98 books of different systems of medicines, 54 for Ayurveda, 30 for Siddha and 14 for Unani. These books are very good reference for manufacturing of the ASU drugs. The second schedule, it mentions the standards which need to be complied with by imported drugs and by drugs manufactured for sale, stocked or exhibited for sale or distribution. Further, Schedule A, which is relating to the different types of forms that relates to the ASU drugs also, particularly 24D, 24E, 25D, 25E, 26D, 26E, 26E1, 47, 48 and 49. There is a Schedule B1 which relates to the fees for test or analysis by pharmacopeia laboratory for Indian medicine or the government analyst. Schedule E1 relates with the list of poisonous substance under ASU systems of medicines. Schedule FF, standards for ophthalmic preparations. Schedule T, already we have discussed in the last slide. This relates with the good manufacturing practices for ASU medicines and which is need to be strictly complied by all ASU manufacturers. Schedule Y, which relates with the requirements and guidelines for permission to import and or manufacture new drugs for sale or to undertake the clinical trials. Drugs and Cosmetic Rules 1945, Part 16, Rule 151 to 160 relates with the manufacture for sale of Ayurvedic including Siddha or Unani drugs. Part 16A, Rule 160A to 160J relates with the approval of the institutions for carrying out tests on ASU drugs and raw materials used in their manufacture. Part 17, Rule 161 relates to the labeling, packaging and limit of alcohol in ASU drugs. Part 17, Rule 161B, shelf life or date of expiry for ASU medicines. There is very common questions in everyone's mind that whether ASU medicines are having any expiry. Yes, most of the ASU medicines are having the expiry, and for more details, this rule should be read. Part 18, Rule 162-167 relates to the government analysts and inspectors for ASU drugs. Part 19, Rule 168-170 relates to the standards of ASU drugs. And the proposed Schedule Z, which relates to the requirements and guidelines related to mandatory clinical trials of ASU drugs to manufacture ASU drugs for sale. This Schedule Z is proposed by Ayush in 2012, but it is opposed by many of the herbal industries due to the mandatory clinical trials requirement. It is still in a discussion. Hope, students, you have understood that there are different regulations for the ASU drugs. ASU drugs are very strictly regulated in India. Thank you.